And the Frame for Frame Festival returns to Arlington this weekend. The festival features independent films, many locally made, as well as visual arts and music. And with that, we welcome Festival Director James Hawthorne here. Thank you for joining us.
Glad to be here.
And filmmaker Reginald Titus. Thank you all for coming to Midday. We're so happy to have you. James, this year for your festival, what can we all expect? And congratulations as well.
Well, thank you. Yeah, it's year three. And so I think you can expect a big diversity of films. Mm-hmm. Films that we hope, anyway, will inspire people to think Arlington when they think of film, because you don't always think Arlington, and you probably don't think Arlington at all when you
Cowboys,
think of film. Think Cowboys, Rangers, right.
Six Flags. So why Arlington?
Well, because Arlington doesn't have any recognition, if you will, when it comes to the film community. And there are a lot of good things happening in the film community in Arlington. And so our festival is just a way to shine a spotlight on some of those good things that are happening in terms of film in the Arlington community.
Because I've heard here, you know, I moved here, it's not DFW, it's DAFW, from what I understand people
well,
say, putting
Arlington like
to think in there.
That. We like to think that, and we like to think it for film
as well. Of course, and that's a big one there. Let's talk about some of the features that you're going to be presenting, like Edge of the World. Where was that one made?
That film was made by a filmmaker, Randy Redload, who's out of California. Mm-hmm. But anyway, it's a film that really talks about a person's, it challenges the faith that people go through and how their faith gets challenged at times. And so I think it's a wonderful film that inspires people to their faith through some of the sports activities that take place in the film. And it's just a really good film about why you should stay committed to a cause, I guess. Mm-hmm. And sometimes we all get our faith challenged.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a very good point.
And this film, you know, speaks to that and speaks to why you also should stay the course.
I mean, it's so cool to see these filmmakers just bringing all these different sorts of stories, different characters and voices that need to be heard. I think about a short, it's called Popcorn, My Heart, Popcorn and Chocolate. Is that Popcorn and Chocolate?
Popcorn.
And I was in band, so I thought this was kind of cool here. Would you mind explaining to people what that one's about?
Yeah, Popcorn and Chocolate. It's a film that really speaks to military service, and how sometimes we ought to always, we don't take for granted the service I get that these people give in order to make our country free and protect the freedoms that we have. And so it really speaks to the recognition to the veterans and what they do and how they supply service to our country. And we should never forget, you know, the contributions that they make. And so it's just a wonderful film that really puts all of that into perspective.
With the ultimate sacrifice
there. With the ultimate sacrifice,
and of course,
absolutely,
the band members raising money and helping out those endeared members of our community there.
Right.
And of course, another feature, and this is why you're here, Mr. Titus, to talk about your film, Natural Hair. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about it. There's so many different voices when it comes to hair. I think about the big documentary Chris Rock did years back and everything. That told one side of a story, but yours tells something a bit different.
Yes, Natural, the movie, it's a documentary. It tells about the struggles of hair identity told by women of color, specifically women in America. And on the outs, when you first think about, you know, natural hair, you think the movie is about natural hair, but when you start to dive into it, you realize there's layers to it, you know, from slavery to American history to economics to entrepreneurship, social politics. So whenever we show this film, we get a lot of conversations started, and it continues on. So,
well, can we take a peek of it? I think we've got a little bit to look at.
Demetria Obilor was also publicly judged on social media for her natural curves and natural hair.
The controversy is coming from people who aren't too happy with the way that I look on television, saying, oh, her body is too big for that dress, or she's too curvy, or her hair is unprofessional, it's crazy, we don't like it. A quick word to those people.
Wow, this is a story that touches so many people, and me just working in the community. I mean, I get to hear from so many different women of color and what it means to them to be able to just be themselves. Why did you want to make Natural Hair the movie?
So the whole point of the film is we want, whenever someone brings their daughter or their wife to the film, to feel empowered. When the film is finished, we want the women to feel empowered and positive about their self-image. Which way they decide to wear their hair, we just want them to feel good inside.
Well, I like all the different elements you bring to it, because oftentimes people get confused when we bring up topics like cultural appropriation and why there might be an issue when you have, you know, maybe a blonde Caucasian woman who's, you know, sporting an afro one day and gets a wig, and people aren't too happy with it.
Right.
And you're like, what's the big deal? You know, I just love, I love the fro, but it's like you don't understand everything that a black person goes through, and it's not cool when we do it.
Right.
It's unprofessional when we do it.
Right.
It's, you know, it lacks taste. I mean, I've heard things about my hair, people telling me literally while I'm anchoring this show on Facebook, messaging me, saying, I don't care what your culture, the creed, the religion, you got to do something about that hair. But this is the way I was born, and that's why I love the message that you're sending through that film, and I think that speaks to the diversity of the festival that you put on here, because there's so many different stories there. Wow, gentlemen, thank you so much. I'm excited. Now you know you got me going right now. Frame for Frame opens tomorrow and runs through Sunday. The film portion will take place at Studio Movie Grill, Lincoln Square. The music and art have separate venues. For schedules and ticket information, go to frameforframe.org. We're sending it over to Jesse now. Thank you so much, John.